Prepare yourself, America, because it's happening right now. Small towns across the country are being infiltrated by something they've never seen before. The first ever comedy, variety, reality kind of game-based anything-goes sort of show.
That impresses people, right?
Every Sunday, 200 residents of one small town become stars by doing the most outrageous things, and you never know what will happen.
That's your house, isn't it? It's gone.
Small Town America, get ready for your close-up. My Kind of Town premieres now, only on ABC. Welcome to My Kind of Town, where we flew 200 residents from Greenville, Alabama to New York City to be part of a studio audience where they have no idea what's in store. Like this woman's discovery that there's no place like home, literally. And this man will take on a giant 50-foot robot set loose on the streets of Greenville. And in the end, all 200 Greenvillians could go home with fantastic prizes if their neighbor here doesn't blow the big test. It's My Kind of Town, and it starts right now.
I like the kind of place where you know everybody's face.
Cause I'm a small town
kind of guy. I like a neighborhood that's cozy. As a neighbor, I'm quite nosy.
I'm a small town
kind of guy. I've been to New York, London, Paris, but I'm not a bit embarrassed to admit I'm more at ease with fewer people and more trees.
Where you can get to know each other.
There's so much to discover
if you're not shy.
That's why
I'm a small town kind of guy.
Greenville, Alabama. Now, this looks like my kind of town.
Thank you very much. Welcome to My Kind of Town. Where are you from?
Greenville.
What state's that in?
Alabama.
And what's your local crop?
Steering wheels.
Yeah, it's not technically a crop, but keeping America on the straight and narrow. Try driving a car without one, gang. Now, there is a distinct possibility that later on, all 200 of you could win an amazing prize, but only if this man, Jason Pouncey, remembers the names of all the people we meet tonight from his hometown of Greenville. Yeah. Jason, I've got to ask you, do you have a good memory? Do you have quite a good memory?
No, sir.
You really don't?
I've often referred to it as Swiss cheese because it's got a lot of gaps and holes.
Oh, no. Now, Jason, I'll tell you why we picked you. It wasn't because of your memory. We didn't know that. We picked you because you said on your application to the show, you're known for your willingness to do anything.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. You should be careful what you write on applications to national television shows, is all I can say. And a lot of you are going to find that out tonight. You wait and see. Those application forms, deadly. A viper in the bosom. Okay. Try to relax and concentrate on the names. Let's show the rest of America the wonders of lovely Greenville, Alabama. Here we go. Greenville is home to the famous hickory smoked turkey sandwich. The turkeys are not only smoked, they're furious. Greenville goes crazy for high school football. Sadly, the Greenville Tigers had just 2 wins last season. Greenville survived Hurricane Ivan. Currently, a tropical storm in the vicinity of Puerto Rico is gaining strength and heading north, destination unknown. Okay, Greenville's a small town with true southern charm. Look how beautiful this town is. But we did find something in Greenville that offends all senses, something that makes every Greenvillian's stomach turn. And that is these disgusting, odious, offensive pair of size 17 sandals. Oh, show your disgust. Oh, they're vile. They're spiteful and they're vile. And I can tell you now, they are owned by Greenville's tallest resident, and that's you, Todd Campbell. How you doing, Todd? You all right, man? Nice to see you. Okay, here we go. Oh, okay. Now, why are you so attached to those rather spiteful shoes, I would say?
They're comfortable.
They're comfortable. Yeah, I'd have used another word there other than comfortable. Yeah. Okay, but they are your sandals, or I would say, because they're so manly, mandals.
That's correct.
They are, okay. Now, you are also, I gather, Greenville's tallest resident, is that right?
I would say that would be correct.
You're quite a man to have around if anyone needs a light bulb changing, I would think.
You can say that.
A 7-foot man, no need for a stepladder there. Wow. Okay, now, Todd, can I be blunt? Your sandals are offensive, and don't just take my word for this. Have a look on the screen. Here we go.
Frankly, Todd, when you wear those sandals, I tell people you are adopted.
Todd Campbell, you bring shame to the town of Greenville for those things you call sandals.
Todd, we have two letters for you. P-U.
There we go, that's a whole town thing now. Okay, do you know what? We think it's time to do Greenville a favor and get rid of those sandals. Now, we could use conventional weapons, but that might take years and cost millions of lives. In the end, we opted for trial by fire. Come on, Todd, let's torch the sandals. Let's go. Like that. Okay. Like to stand like that, that'd be beautiful. Face the screen, please. Okay, Todd, let's go to Greenville right now and check back in. There's your sandals. Now, I can tell you now, those sandals are in an isolated location. The only shoes in the state of Alabama that officially qualify as vermin. Okay, all you're gonna do is to rid the town of the health hazard you call footwear, is take this megaphone and yell the word, incinerate, yeah? Now, obviously, your sandals cannot spontaneously combust. That's why we have another Greenville fireman there. Would you please welcome Demetrius Bogan, ladies and gentlemen, Demetrius Bogan. He's standing by, trust me. He's standing by to send them out in a blaze of glory. Demetrius, how many sandal cremations do you do a year?
Actually, this is my first one.
Okay, it's his first one. It's his first one. I think you'll get the hang. Todd, please man your megaphone and we'll do the countdown. You just got to say incinerate after the 5 count. Okay, you ready, gang? Yeah. You ready out there? Demetrius, are you ready? Okay, here we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Incinerate.
There we go. They're off. They're off. There you go. Do you know what? That's put me in the mood for some more fire-related fun. What else have you got to torch? Let's have a little look what else we can burn. Okay. That's your backyard, yeah?
That's right.
Okay, let's see. You've got your shed there.
Right.
Your beloved pickup truck. Do you love that pickup truck? And there's your tractor.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, hypothetically, if you had to get rid of just one of those things, which one would you get rid of?
It'd have to be the tractor.
Have to be the tractor. Not the truck, your beloved pickup truck.
No.
Don't you want us to destroy your truck? Come on. Okay. That's good news for two reasons. Firstly, we already moved it to be with the man who put the fire in fireman, Demetrius Bogan. And secondly, for making the right choice, look what I've got you. This, we'll have a look. Roll it in. There we go. That there, unless I'm very much mistaken, is a John Deere 790 compact tractor with 27 horsepower engine and an LX6 rotary cutter attachment for all your mowing needs. Todd, according to your mum, who I spoke to, this is the tractor of your dreams. In order to get it, you must destroy your old one. Once again, the command is incinerate. Todd, man the megaphone. Let's count down. Demetrius, You know what to do here. Let's have the five count. You get ready with the incinerate right. Command. In five.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Incinerate.
Okay, come on, work for me, baby. Look, it's against all his instincts to start fires.
Come on, dude. Incinerate, Demetrius, incinerate.
Oh, look. Okay. Do you know what? That is so unsatisfying. Your tractor isn't destroyed at all. The fireman, he's used to putting out fires. It seems he can't stop. What we need to destroy this tractor is, I don't know, a 40-foot-high electro-hydro-mechanical monster with jaw-crushing force of 24,000 pounds per square inch and a nose that spits fire at 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit. If only we had something like that in Greenville. Wait, whoa, 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 hang on. Was it? Huh? You're kidding me. We've actually got something like that, gang. Okay, wait a second, gang. Here we go. We've got something like that. Great news, Todd. Look at Commerce Street in Greenville. Have a look at that. That's the Robosaurus, ladies and gentlemen. Gang, what a happy coincidence. What a happy coincidence. The very day we need a Robosaurus on the streets of Greenville, one shows up. It's amazing. Okay, good thing you all left town, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, Tub. Robosaurus, I gather now, is with your tractor. Here it comes. Okay, let's have the count, gang. Let's have the count. Five,
four, three, two, one.
Okay, here he goes. 24,000 pounds per square inch of crushed power. 3,000. Don't back off. What's happening? Where's he going? Hang on a second. What's it? Oh no. What's it? Oh my. I knew this would happen. It's out of control. Oh no. Stop it, it's out of control. Oh no! No! Todd, hide your eyes. Hide your eyes. Oh no! This is. I can't look. I cannot look. How good's your insurance? He's pulled the truck, your beloved truck, in half. The agony. Oh no. I can't believe that. You love that truck, right? It's your pride and joy. Todd, I swear I don't know how your truck got there. I feel sick about that. You really loved that truck, didn't you? And the truck... Do you know, I knew the Robosaurus would get out of control. Todd, I'm not the sort of man who destroys another man's truck. You know what? It's a truck-alike. There's your truck, safe and sound. It's all right. It was a truck-alike. Whoa. Bad news is, in order to win the tractor, you must let the out-of-control Robosaurus loose again. For the last time, man your megaphone. Here we go.
Incinerate!
Big cheer now, gang. Yay! You've won a John Deere tractor. Let's take a look at it. Sit on board. Tractor. Have a look at this. Look at that. Oh! Some brand new mandals. Size 70. 7 foot. Todd Campbell, let's hear it, gang. Oh! Hold on tight. Because when we come back, this woman gets some shocking news. Her house is no longer on her property. Don't go away. Oh, Todd Campbell.
Out with old school foundation and in with a revolution. Maybelline New York brings you Dream Matte Mousse. touch it. Only an Air Whip mousse could feel this air soft. Blend this evenly. Deliver pure matte perfection. A breakthrough foundation. Dream Matte Mousse by Maybelline New York.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
Now the amazing air soft feel in blush. New Dream Mousse Blush.
Whirlpool presents Fresh Ideas for the Kitchen, now available at Best Buy. Introducing our newest innovation, a refrigerator that saves you time. With the new Fast Fill Water Dispenser, you can fill any size container twice as fast. At Best Buy, get it today and get free delivery. Need more help in the kitchen? Get Whirlpool at Best Buy and get more done.
From the producer of Shrek and Shrek 2, meet Valiant.
Mom, it's time I left the nest.
You were such a cute little egg.
A very little pigeon.
Reporting for duty, sir.
With very big dreams.
You know they'll send a crack team to rescue me.
From Walt Disney Pictures.
It's not the size of your wingspan.
Yeah!
It's the size of your spirit.
We're dead.
Discover just how far...
Push me luck!
...a hero can go. Oh, Valiant, rated G.
At least have some breakfast before you go home.
Only in theaters August 19th.
Mom!
There's a new pulse in the world. New Oral-B Pulsar. A whole new kind of manual brush. Micropulse bristles pivot and pulse deep between teeth for a truly superior clean. New Oral-B Pulsar.
Wouldn't it be great having a smaller waist?
I fit as a fiddle and feeling so good. Why I would jump over.
According to a study, dairy foods rich in calcium, like Yoplait yogurt, could help you lose more weight than just cutting calories alone, especially around your waistline.
I haven't a worry, I have
Yoplait. Lose weight, gain a waist. Now Yoplait's great taste. In new Yoplait smoothie, an original and light.
Denzel Washington, Remember the Titans, Monday at 8, 7 Central, only on ABC.
Greenville's own Cecil Moody on the Appalachian Dulcimer Gang. Oh! Okay, welcome back to My Kind of Town. I'm here with 200 people from Greenville, Alabama. The reason they are so excited is because they all could go home tonight, winners. But, there's a big but here, only if local fireman Jason Pouncey remembers the names and faces of every person from Greenville we meet tonight when we play our dramatic end game, Name Your Neighbours. Jason... Now, wait, gang, you must be curious, a little bit curious, what prize you could win from everyone in Greenville here tonight. Yeah. Admit it, I've got you interested, haven't I? You're interested. You're slightly thinking, yeah, it's about other people, but you're also thinking, what's in it for me? Me. What am I going to get? Yeah, that guy won a tractor. What about me? Me. Okay. Greenville, I'll tell you what that prize is. Have a look. Bring it on. Scooter, this T&G stylish Venice scooter. It has a two-stroke air-cooled engine, electric and kickstart options, and spacious under-the-seat storage. Jeddo,
yes.
Pro Temp Mayor, I'm glad to see you are wearing a brain bucket. Thank you very much. Now, Jason, 200 scooters up for grabs tonight for every single member of this audience. Now let's talk about pressure. That is a lot of pressure. I hope that's going to focus you and perhaps fill in some of those holes in that cheese-like mind.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah? OK. Go from Swiss cheese to cheddar.
That's right. There you go.
Let's check back in on Greenville. You all flew here this morning. We should probably check and make sure you're all not getting wrong. Are you Tammy and Drew Gaston? I know you are. Tammy and Drew, let's just check your house, see everything's all right there. Let's have a little look. Oh, there's Tammy and Drew Gaston. Tammy and Drew Gaston. Have you got that? Tammy and Drew Gaston. Look at them. There they are.
Tammy
and Drew. A lot of pressure. Everything good at your house?
No.
Let's go to Ellen and Bob Glasscock. Hello there.
Hello.
Okay. Once again, Ellen and Bob Glasscock. There we go. Let's have a look at your house. Oh, that's lovely. You should have painted, yeah. But still, all looks good. There's no robbery going on there. It looks peaceful. It looks safe. What about you, Edna Kelly? Let's go have a little look at your house, shall we? And I'm sitting down, which is bad news for you. Let's have a look at your house. You probably want to check up on it. Let's go there now. Here we go. There it is. Okay, that's your house, isn't it?
Yeah.
Are you all right?
Uh-huh.
Are you feeling a slight bit of worry?
Yeah.
That's fine. Okay, here we go. That's how it looked when you last saw it. Is that correct?
Uh-huh.
I love that look of fear. I love that. That's how it looked when you last saw it. Everything nice and secure, everything looks nailed down, looks good.
Yeah.
Let's make sure. Is this our most recent shot of Edna's house, Control? Let's see if we can find out. Apparently it's not. Let's have a little look at the most recent shot. Here we go. I've got to find out what's happening, and not even I know. It's gone. Where's your house? It seems has your house ever left before?
No.
You never had to go looking for it? You never thought, where's my house?
No.
Never happened before?
No.
Well, that's all very strange.
Yes, it is.
What's that? Hang on, wait a second. Something's coming in now from our ABC WNCF affiliate in Montgomery, Alabama, and I think they've got a very important breaking story. Let's go over there right now.
Today, a local house has escaped from a trailer park. The house is reportedly on the run. Tony Beckham is on the scene in Greenville. And Tony, I understand this story hits a little too close to home for one Greenville woman.
That's right, Brian. The house on the run is owned by this woman. Edna Kelly, a special education aide, has lived in Greenville all her life. Our ABC 32 news chopper was on the scene when the house gave the police an unexpected, clever slip. Roadblocks have been set up surrounding Greenville, and police officers are now suspecting that the house may have had special forces training.
In all my years on the job, I've never seen a house like this. It's unstoppable.
Edna Kelly is said to be out of town today, but Edna's husband, Leroy Kelly, is, believe it or not, inside the house. One can only assume that he's been held hostage.
Yeah!
Now, the police had the house cornered until it opened fire with 20 rounds of tea saucers, some toilet paper, and one television. Clearly, neighbors and friends are just baffled by this turn of events.
It's always been such a quiet house. I never expected the house would leave the block like this.
Tony Beckham from the ABC 32 SWAT team, reporting from Greenville. Back to you, Brian.
Another reminder to lock your doors and chain your homes to a post. I'm Brian Gettle. Good night.
There we go. What is that about? Edna, your house is on the run. This is shocking, very shocking indeed.
Yes.
Do you have any idea where the house could be running for? Where do you think where do you think it's headed?
I don't know.
I don't know either. Let me have a look. Okay. Now, we heard it's a dream of yours, Edna, to move your house and live on your sister's property, right near your sister there. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, well, your house has the same dream. Yeah. Yeah? You didn't know that about your house. It has a secret inner life, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take a look at the land, because I think the house has taken on itself to make it this happen. Here you go. Oh, that's a great bit of land, is it not?
Yeah.
It's a lovely bit of land. about that.
Nice.
So it is, it's a beautiful piece of land. That makes me think Sweet Home Alabama, gang. Yeah. It really does. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you for the yee-haw. Can I get a yee-haw? Let's take a look at what we did since you left Greenville, Edna. Here we go. Took your house, uprooted it, split it in half, moved it to the new location, mowed the lawn, put your stuff back in, landscaped, and then put the stairs on the front. Would you believe, you might have seen the house through your television at local law enforcement offices. So we've even moved your husband too. Here he is with your new 42-inch plasma TV. Oh! Do you know what, gang? He can't wait for you to get home, ladies and gentlemen. Edna Kelly and her sister Eugenie. There you go, babe. Give us a big kiss. Give us a big kiss. Yeah. There we go.